These are my views for nieces and nephews who may be confused about why BLM and Black is on blast in the news every day and being used to light the New World Order fuse. And the truth is, that's problematic. So as truthers, can we talk about that for, say, 30 minutes? Yes, I know. No, he was not a king. He was an actor. No, he was not a hero. He played one in the Disney Marvel Lucasfilm produced Black Panther movie. But he also played other heroes, which is a word we get from Heru, going all the way back to the original superhero idea. The real and only true superhero is the Messiah. And Heru was one of those spirits which came and manifested itself as a god unto men in order to be worshipped and to promise men that they too could be as gods. So we've had this big craze of superhero movies, arguably coming to a climax with Marvel's Endgame to some, and to others with the Black Panther movie. But because, and the other heroes that he played, again, were pop culture icons, people who were idolized and looked up to, and in their own right, considered heroes at the time. Jackie Robinson, James Brown, Thurgood Marshall. So, because I'm not a person that's given to always absorb and believe the narrative as it may have been given to me, I cannot help but see the symbolic meaning of his passing. I do not know whether that symbolic meaning was amplified by some sort of deception concerning his sickness. It may have been like all sickness and death, simply a result of sin, something that we will all one day have to experience unless, of course, we're able to be taken up and worthy of that as much as we can be. But regardless of if it was organic or not, the announcement of his death and the timing at which it was announced, when taking into consideration the other Black-centered news stories, makes me have to make some symbolic connections, because that's how I think. You don't have to think the same way. And again, because of the brotherhoods that he would have had to have been a part of and the way they operate, I don't believe that this is as much a coincidence as a coincidence that aligns with the theme of the times. The occult symbolism that governs this devilish world is sick and thick. Chadwick, well, we have the Chad situation become the Chaz situation in Seattle, and a wick is used to ignite, say, a candle or dynamite. But oddly enough, the Google Doodle on the morning before the afternoon when we found out about Chadwick's death, the Google Doodle happened to feature Alexandre Dumas, who is the writer of one of the first masked superhero stories that gained worldwide attention, and that would be The Three Musketeers. And also in the Google Doodle was a lot of symbolism that we could relate to Freemasonry, or what we like to call the Brotherhoods, because there are so many other organizations that are involved. But whenever we look at this symbolism, we have to realize sometimes it's organic, because we do have a spiritual reality that we often ignore, but it's always at play. And then sometimes these things are plays that are orchestrated by the powers that should not be, who are fixated upon the occult and the symbols of the occult. And if those powers also have control over the media, it is intelligent to note that they are also fixated upon Black right now, especially. Even the truthers who have been talking about Billy Goats, Bill Gates of Hell, and his role in this plandemic and this phantom menace play Of course, he has the money and the power to suppress the news about his shady dealings in vaccinating blacks abroad, but here in America, where black and white brotherhoods have come together to create chaos and race war. So-called blacks are not only key to the discussion about civil unrest these days, but also key to the discussion about the pandemic and this disease that seems to, we're told, target black people more so because of their diet, etc. This is all part of the chaos that is in the air due to the spirit over the land, the dominating spirit, the prevailing spirit, the spirit with dominion at this time is indeed the spirit of chaos, the spirit of duality, this spirit represented by Horus, also called Gemini, the astrological equivalent of Horus. This is Crowley's Aeon of Horus, symbolized by duality and the mantra, laugh now, cry later, which just so happens to incorporate, or that phrase is usually incorporated with the symbols of Gemini, which are the masks. The masks of Gemini relate back to the ancient actors of Greece and the transformative nature that the masks would take on when the actor would don the mask, usually the mask of one of the Greek gods, to play out one of the Greek tragedies or comedies, as you get the two masks usually representing tragedy and comedy. And the dual nature, the equal opposite nature of those two opposing emotions has to do with the conflict of inner self, and a conflict that is important to create when creating an undetectable mind control slave. So this is indeed a ritual to induce a alter personality, which is where method acting really stems from, the ability to lose yourself and allow for the spirit that you're playing or portraying to inhabit you. This is what made the best actors. It is the time of revelation, where things are being revealed. We see the apparent evidence of a technocratic, modernized, but just as lawless and demonic return to the ancient days of Noah. We see things we've long thought of as staples of society being plucked out, as a falsely publicized new normal is shaping up more and more each day to be evidence of a new world. Foundational truther movement visionaries, old schoolers like Bill Cooper, A. Ralph Epperson, Tex Mars, Steve Coakley, and others like them pointed out the occult meanings to many things today that prove the existence of a devil that has been successful at hiding behind symbolism and yet still managing to operate with immunity in plain sight. His religion, witchcraft, New Age, has merged almost seamlessly into the daily lives of the children, who are primed and ready to live in a society unbound by the religious restrictions that once refined and defined maturity, morality, and virtue. This is the New Age, also called the Age of Aquarius by the crafters of the 60s hippie counterculture psyop. A new and magical time that many incoherently navigated through with the aid of hallucinogenic drugs and a reckless reliefs from even the most self-preserving inhibitions. A new and magical time that many incoherently navigated through with the aid of hallucinogenic drugs and a reckless release from even the most self-preserving inhibitions. Turns out it wasn't such a new time, but a return to a Masonic ideal society from the Brotherhood perspective. A mythologized New Atlantis where magic, free thinking, free love, and free drugs reshaped the minds of the misguided and overprivileged majority middle-class youth into the self-absorbed geniuses of the me generation from the cocaine 80s. In the more distant past, we saw the Age of Reason, the Age of Enlightenment, and the Renaissance or Rebirth era not as successfully attempt to bring mankind into this new age or eon of magic. And unbeknownst to the mainstream minded, this era of witchcraft, symbolized by the archetypical magician, the Joker, the trickster, Hermes, it is this entity's magic which the Sabbatean cult and subsequent Zionist movements adopted. The Hermetic or Hermes-inspired magicians of pop culture shape our definitions of art, cinema, music, and fashion. So we have long been in the middle of the age of Hermes, the trickster. Crowley understood this and rather deceptively expressed it as the aeon or age of Horus, the Egypto-Greco version of Greek Hermes, or Egyptian Heru, which is where we get the word hero from, and who became Mercury later among the Romans. The age that we are in is the age of the Antichrist, who can be seen astrologically as Gemini, but the seasons will still change the way they've been changing, so that we will have a combination of the effect of the normal change in seasons in conjunction with the James 1 and 8 spirit of duality in the air, causing chaos amidst the normal, quote, astrological changes that these astral theists look towards. They have this pagan trinity idea, a sun, fire, stag, father, god. Number two, a moon, earth, or water, mother, goddess. And number three, their little dualized bastard offspring, a false divine child savior who may be twins in some cultures or a dual-minded child in others. In ancient Egypt, this is expressed as Osiris, Isis, and Horus, and within astrology, this is expressed as Aries, Taurus, and Gemini. But all those different cultures and different occultic practices use different names. It's always the same idea, that the spirit of Antichrist is the spirit of chaos and duality. And this is the spirit that the Brotherhood count on to help its members become altar personalities or become sacrificed on the altar, at least personality-wise, so that a spirit that is to aid them in getting up the Masonic ladder can come in. This is why they become so dualized and oftentimes will exhibit at least some traits of schizophrenia. Not just the stars of athletics and entertainment, but the politicians, because this is an ancient practice of kings to do this to their children, in order to cause for those children to be quote-unquote exceptional. They would split them, split their personalities through some form of trauma-based mind control so that they could have this dual nature or this Gemini spirit. Them, the child, that particular original personality, and the entity that they've opened themselves up to share one body and therefore become one. This is the way that they believe that you achieve godhood. And this is what the brotherhood and the sisterhoods of this world truly intend for their members, although some members never reach that particular level because their engagement or their involvement in the brotherhood or the sisterhood didn't take them to that degree. And then for others, it most certainly does. You see, the devil must reveal himself in some way. It keeps the game clean. He's as old as the most ancient of secrets from the earth's beginning. It's not only sporting of the grand jester, the ultimate player, the sportiest gamer, that old trickster, the big joker of the deck, to adhere to certain rules of engagement. It gives this adversary, the accuser, a chance to charge man and accuse him before God. O Most High, says the devil, I clearly marked my trick as being a trap. It bears my marking, yet the human still took it, accepting me while disobeying you, O Holy Almighty One. for you or I. It seems counterintuitive to say incriminating words in a song which is being recorded in order for mass production and worldwide distribution. But for some artists, it fulfills a Luciferian contractual obligation, if not simply a desire to delight in duping or tricking the adoring but undiscerning fan into agreement. The most unwitting and spellbound fan addicts will irrationally, even violently defend the most popular stars, quote unquote, with no knowledge or interest in even the most rational and researched critiques of their favorites. We see this starstruck spell take effect in Trump supporters and in BLM supporters, both being used as useful idiots by the true powers that be, who only use the two political party system as a way to polarize America and to centralize their one world plan and make it appear as if they have support on both sides. When one particular side becomes too disenfranchised, then they allow for a president to rise up to represent that side. But at the end of the day, left wing, right wing, the same dragon. Look at how people were manipulated. Truthers were manipulated. Both those who consider themselves black truthers, and they've been manipulated into moving into African witchcraft by its various forms, through so many promotions of it in pop culture, like Beyonce's Black is King, Lovecraft County, the new Candyman movie, the new Jamie Foxx movie, Project Power, and so many other new examples of this idea that, yes, there is a power out there for you, but it does not come through God. And when you're taught to see yourself as God, then you automatically will take the real God out of the conversation. Thus, a psychological race war has begun in this nation. And one thing that's as effective as a martyred leader is a wounded warrior. The white power structure puppets who fight in the names of a people whom they care not for have elevated everything to another level of chaos, not only bringing more destruction and fear to U.S. citizens, but also forcibly and wickedly causing many hearts to wax cold towards and hate their neighbors, even Israel. And the next level of escalation in this state was the so-called shooting of Jacob Blake. Jacob, from whom the 12 tribes of Israel come, and Blake, which oddly means both black and white. So now something here ain't right. Whether or not he's a criminal, a victim, or a myth, being a multiple gunshot victim at the hands of police, dope men, or stick-up kids should not be the qualification for a hero. But he will be made a hero by the very white, liberal, heterophobic, and prejudiced powers that pull BLM's puppet strings. This has the symbolism of a psyop and all the markings of masonic duping delight. 7. Completion. Shots. No blood. But what has been completed by this act? And organic or orchestrated, could it be that the symbolism here is saying that Jacob S. Black? Even the middle initial S, which is the 19th letter in our alphabet, has already played prominent in the Phantom Menace story. Of course, COVID-19 and 19 symbolizing the lowest and the highest number, 1 and 9, or the first and the last. 19 symbolizes the Alpha and the Omega. And Blake's derivation is uncertain. It could come from Black, a nickname for someone who had dark hair or skin, or from Blake, a nickname for someone with pale hair or skin. There's your hermetic duality. Conflict, chaos, duality, polarity. Welcome to 2020. An exercise in dualism to make the devil equal with God, to make you think of yourself as a god, to turn everything upside down by presenting the mirror reflection a la Masonic black and white chessboard duality game. Two things happening simultaneously in the black community. You have a great deal of young people who have turned aside from the church because they feel it has nothing to do with them. And then you have a great awakening of young people who have discovered that the Bible has more to do with them than they were ever told. To be clear, whatever you believe, being biblical Israel does not absolve you of responsibility for sin and wickedness. Thus saith the Lord. Pause and read here and see how easily he divorced himself from Israel before. Nor does it guarantee kinship with the Messiah, the King of the Jews called Jesus, who clearly let it be known who was his mother and who was his brother. Don't get it twisted. Yet it does not change the fact that all lies matter. And it matters if they lied about it in the first place. And it is true that they lied about the depiction of Jesus. So why did they change that fact? Which is not a salvation issue for many who are mature within the body of Christ, but it may be a stumbling block if you're young and black. To the mature in the body of Christ, that should have no effect, but it just might be a stumbling block to you if you're young, seeking, and black. And we understand the use of the terms black and white to describe people within a common conversational context. Like institutional racism, this is a uniquely American problem. Yes, racism exists worldwide, but nowhere but in this melting pot is it as all-encompassing, widespread, and disregarding of actual nationality. It is a Masonic construct, the black and white chessboard, upon which many lies that rely on prejudice and polarity are built. The terms black and white take away from the meaning of nationality and help to push us toward this global reality that will require not just one religion, but one race of people, one nationality, one nation under Lucifer. We are kept separated, segregated, and miseducated in order to divide and conquer our human race. Nations are real, validated by scripture and ordained by God. The devil, that trickster, has entered the nations into a race for first place in order to upset the natural design and order of God, causing elder brother to submit to the authority of the younger, which is to author confusion within this house built upon sand. And only God will set the crooked things straight, making the first last and the last first, in order to restore balance to a twisted, perverted, and satanically inverted world, soon and very soon. But until then, we will see chaos and destruction of this old world daily by way of all four core elements, fire, earth, water, and wind, by way of both sexes, both houses of Freemasonry, the two major political parties, and the black and white chessboard dynamic, including the Fraternal Order of Police, White Brotherhoods, and the Prince Hall. A very well-known example of how differently the truth concerning the occult can appear depending upon how many degrees deep you actually went in order to find said truth is found in a close and informed examination of the fabled mystic and magician Hermes thrice great, Hermes thrice mysticus. We are told this being is the Grecian version of Egyptian Thoth, we are told. Remember, occult things are made to seem complex to uninitiated and prying eyes. The truth is that this Hermes figure is really more closely related to Horus, or Heru, as the Egyptians called him. And also, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is not the author of confusion, but the trickster is. For instance, Taurus the bull is the epitome of the queen mother goddess in feminine signs, but a bull is a male. You see, the trickster is Hermes, who is, as a son of legendary ancient Greek father god Zeus, this fallen angel. And this is a myth that spread as one of the many tales that served as preemptive attacks on the concept of the coming Christ, son of the true father, who was from the beginning. So the fallen ones twisted and reenacted elements of the greatest story ever told by telling it first by way of fables fed to pagan peoples like the Dogon tribe, often by their own admission. For folks who breathe a sigh of relief upon discovery of the ancient myths that seem to foreshadow biblical accounts, it becomes a great exemption, a clause that excuses them of the moral parameters that believers have to adhere to. But like the Dogon, Mayan, Persian, Babylonian, Egyptian, Grecian, and Roman ancient peoples that encountered these trickster gods, these deceiving ancient aliens have delighted and duped the progressive, ultra-liberal-leaning youth into believing that history and science, which are mythology in this case, have given them a rational reason to opt out of Abrahamic religions, let alone being devout Christians. Dogon indeed, or a reversal of the curse of no God, spelling spell trick. So though they exhibited a slight degree of advanced cosmological knowledge, they appeared deficient in other measurable examples of cultural advancement. Almost as if they were taught advanced knowledge only on a need-to-know basis. We find in many cultures this evidence of their so-called gods only granting them advancement up to a certain level. And then degradation ensues. Just like the devil in the garden, their temperamental so-called gods use these people as stepping stones and vessels to get their plans off to a running start. Then the gods disappear, as in some cases do the peoples that they manipulated. And they're still manipulating them to this day. Isn't it ironic that Kenosha, where we have recently had this latest, what appears to be PSYOP to help push forward the race war, Kenosha means pike, but do you think that it's related to the fish? Or could it be more likely a hidden or occult reference to Albert? Without stretching, I do find it interesting that Pike's statue was allowed to be toppled. However, in June of 2020, protesters attempted to topple Andrew Jackson's statue in front of the White House, and police stopped it. Is it because Pike is a Brotherhood member who would be down for the sacrifice? Pulling down statues is only a way to erase history and make it easier for those who are in control of how history is told to change the narrative. Pike's importance to the great work of the Brotherhood cannot be overstated. His writing, Morals and Dogma, is a Masonic handbook, and he also has made many quotes that truthers have revealed to the masses concerning how to create chaos in order to bring forth the new world order. Some of his quotes even admitted that Lucifer was the god of his order. Pike talked about the 19, the Alpha and the Omega, according to the order, the beginning and the ending, or the start of a new world order and the end of an old world order. He talked about how nihilists and atheists would be used to help bring about that change. And this is what you're seeing with the BLM narrative. You're seeing the nihilists and the atheists, by and large, liberals who don't believe in a God, who believe as self as God or some other New Age principle or theory, are being used to bring forth the chaos. And the Brotherhood members who will take the mask of Christian will bring in the order. The mystic Wu dynasty, alleged Illuminati family, have apparently influenced pop culture before. God only knows their precise role in the way the Wu flu was used as an excuse to increase NWO control. Wu means shaman. Again, remember, this is a new world order, and all of the brotherhoods across the world are coming together to contribute toward the magnum opus, the great work of causing the old world to go into chaos and collapse so the new world can rise again from the ashes like the phoenix. Brotherhood members in good standing with the Brotherhood from all walks of life appear to have some understanding that this is what's going on today. Some of them understand Aleister Crowley's Aeon of Horus theory and how we are seeing it in full effect. Laugh now, cry later. Gemini, duality. Have you ever seen COVID under the microscope? Do you know if this is how it really looks? You know, when I first saw this depiction, I just couldn't shake an image that it brought to my mind. In order to make sure that the new order stays, population must be reduced so that society can be more easily controlled. Heard of eugenics? Guess who elitists see as a spreading virus and will get out of the way first? The same people who were once bound by the devil of passivity, but now appear to be awakening as if from a curse of deep slumber. News concerning this people and their troubles has gone viral. And from the elite's perspective, you can certainly see why you would compare this particular people to a virus. The way that they spread and their influence spreads. And there's just something about this depiction of the virus that I just can't help but compare to some other images in mind. Again, stereotypical images, thinking from the point of view of the Brotherhood elite. I may be stretching, but where have I seen this before? Why does this remind me of something? I just can't put my finger on it. Ah, yes, it's coming to me now. Maybe it's just me, but I know you're tired of seeing black folks. I know you're tired of hearing black folks tell the truth. I'm tired of them too, just about. I'm just about there myself. I don't blame you. But when you know what the devil is trying to get you to do to resist doing that, you have to first recognize what the devil is trying to get you to do. This is creating a resentment. Do you think that perhaps this oversaturation of the George Soros Antifa-backed, created and executed riots that the media is suspiciously supportive of, do you think it's supposed to make you tired of so-called black lives rather than force you to believe they matter? It's actually producing the opposite effect. Is it possible that part of this deep state deception, formerly and more accurately known as a Babylonian Luciferian world order system, is it possible that this deception is part of a creation of hard hearts, especially among Christians, those who profess to love their neighbor as they do themselves? The truther community at large is a non-white majority. Some of them who are non-white have lived and led lives that cause their concerns to align more so with their white majority neighbors and colleagues. And then for others, it's impossible not to notice that the crosshairs, if not only the spotlight, has been aimed at suspiciously black folks for a large part of 2020. And the boule, the servants of the king, the black leg of the brotherhood, or the quote-unquote Illuminati, they've done their job in helping to push the narrative and to try to convince black folks that they should put aside their suspicions concerning the medical industry. They should put aside their suspicions concerning the government. And it is these sellout leaders that are always placed in front of us in times like these, when the powers that be are attempting to get large portions of the society all on the same page. It is their practice to understand that you have to have certain operatives in place within certain communities who historically mistrust the government and the medical industry, so that you can put these trusted leaders, these trusted implanted leaders, in front of the people that you want to influence. And so we've, for a long time, had our leaders selected, really and truly, by white brotherhoods, who the black boule are only the guardians of. They are the overseers who are sent into the communities in order to distribute propaganda in a way that won't be seen as suspicious, or that the people there won't mistrust as easily. Every black man ain't a brother, and every white man ain't your enemy. Our freedom and the freedom of all is through relationship, ideally friendship, with the Almighty Holy God of Israel, who breaks every chain. Test the spirit by the spirit. And who are we begging for recognition and recognition that we matter? Racist citizens? The Fraternal Order of Police? The Prayers Big Joker? Sleepy Creepy Joe? Who? You beg the system for change, and in exchange you get something strange. This is going to be the second time that they have portrayed someone who is not black as quote-unquote African-American or black in the way that you would think of them as black, growing up in the black community. And they're portraying themselves as black, although they appear to be Asiatic. First time was with Obama, who's more than likely Indonesian, and now with Kamala Harris, who wouldn't take a whiz on a black person to put them out if they was on fire, I'm pretty sure, and it has nothing to do with the quote-unquote black community proper. She's about as African as the wrestler Kamala. Maybe this is some sort of way to connect us to ancient Dravidian mysticism, which you can trace a lot of New Age back to India. You can trace a lot of the practices that people have incorporated into their spiritual regimen as practices that originally came down with the Hindu devils, who established Hinduism, from out of which came Buddhism, and many of the commonly practiced spiritual disciplines of the day that we can kind of all lump under this form of witchcraft called New Age. And when speaking of witchcraft, keep in mind, all of them witches, it's a witchcraft system. An inauguration is a ceremony to make one an augur, or a sorcerer, a soothsayer. Both the Democratic and Republican National Conventions took place in August. Is this because of the meaning of the word August and how it relates to augur? On the conservative side of the aisle, you have the presence of the so-called Christian right, but little do they know, Q who many of them look at as almost some sort of spiritual guide, does have a spiritual system, which is very much in line with the ancient Hindu-based New Age that has swept the world because of its Crowleyan liberality. And so without knowing it or without meaning to, a lot of followers of Trump becoming followers of Q may indeed be following some other intelligence, either an artificial intelligence or something being guided by some spiritual intelligence, aka devil, that's been conjured up in order to keep confusion going on spiritually on the right side of the aisle. Left wing, right wing, same dragon. Love him, hate him, or indifferent, Mike was right about one thing. They don't really care about us. Not Trump and Pence, Biden and Harris, MSN, MSM, CNN, MTV, Fox, LGB, BLM, Sean King, or Ben Jealous. Ben Jealous of you trying to take your place. Think for yourself. Pick and vet leaders, not tweeters, but folks experienced in the streeters. See the trend. Don't just follow the narrative sheepishly. These folks play chess. You're playing checkers. And if you don't understand the rules of the game before you begin, you've already lost. From the increasing number of domestic mass shootings to about the past half decade spike in the publicity of the police brutality problem that people from the inner cities have too long kept as a dirty little secret, these high-profile stories and the unrest will implode major cities and eventually the suburbs and small towns they feed. This is an old agenda that old truthers have been watching and waiting for a long time. The more recently woke folks appear to be the targeted persons that fail to see the devilish manipulation of their younger hearts and minds. Nothing goes on here and gets publicity without the red and blue hand being involved. The Scottish Rite, represented by red, quite often, and the York Rite, represented by blue, as the Blue Lodge. And whenever you see these colors in prominent display surrounding news stories like this, you can bet that something is amiss. Something is being said and done that you don't understand because of your lack of belief in the brotherhood structure or your lack of understanding of it. But whenever you see athletes, entertainers, media personalities all coming together with the same sounding points, with the same talking points, you can bet that it's because their brotherhoods have told them all to run a particular narrative on the uninitiated masses, you and I, the regular folks, who don't think that the world is that controlled, who would not like to believe that there are hidden hands behind sports and entertainment and politics and the news that pull the strings, all in order to create one world order in the end, an order under Lucifer, an order that the brotherhoods and the sisterhoods of this world have all been established in order to build. And that new world order we're seeing come into full fruition as the old world order crumbles before our very eyes. A revolution that is televised is a revolution that you should question if you're wise. And are these incidents really coincidence when it seems so many sides coincide? Well, you decide, but from the truth do not hide. This is about more than black pride. Why is it that this revolution is being televised.
Money.